Welcome back, and in this video, we're going to take our application and make it functional by adding a little MVVM to it using XAML. So what is MVVM? It stands for Model View View Model. So if you're used to MVC, it's a lot like that, but except with a little more V's and a little more M's. So let's break it down a little bit. The model in MVVM stands for data. And now this is just the data that you're passing around. The view in MVVM is your user interface, or our page in Xamarin Forms. And it's the page that we happen to build up with XAML. Now, let's talk about the cool thing in MVVM, and that's the view model. So, the view model is the brains of your app. It's what's going out and talking to various web services or doing any application logic for your page. It's what makes everything work. And it's composed of several properties. Now, what's neat about these properties is that they're bound to UI controls on the view. So let's say you had an entry and you're typing into this entry. Well, if that entry is bound to the view model, that view model's property is automatically going to be updated as you type into it. And the same thing, if that view model's property changes, the UI is going to change automatically as well when it's bound to that property. And it also automatically fires commands. So let's say you had a button. A button has a command property. So when a user taps on it, the command's action gets fired. So a view model has properties, which are bound to UI displays. It also has commands, which react to users' actions on it. So let's get going and add some MVVM goodness to our application. So this is the app as we left it last time, but we're going to add an ability to show a list every time the user types in a note and clicks save. So what I did is I went ahead and I just created a class called Main Page View Model. Now generally with MVVM, you're going to have one view model per page. Now with this Main Page View Model, what you're going to implement is iNotify property changed on it. And so what that does is that it's going to let the view know that anytime a property changed. And so it does have an interface that we have to notify. And what that is just a property changed. So once we get that there, I want to then implement a string to model the note. So it's going to be public string, the note, and this is just going to be a plain property as far as the getter is concerned, returning the note, but it's where the setter comes in is where the interesting part happens. So instead of just setting the note equal to a value coming in, which I do want to do, I also want to create an argument of a property change event args. And that's going to pass in a name of the property here, the note. So what this is going to do is it's going to let the view who happens to be listening to it know that the note property changed. And then finally, I want to invoke that property changed event. So make sure something is subscribed to it, invoke it, and just call this, and then pass the args to it. So now what happens is I have the note property, and it's all hooked up, so when something's bound to it, it's going to change anytime the note changes in the view model, and the view model is going to change this property anytime the note changes in the view. And so the next thing I'm going to create is a command. So the commands are going to be, I'm going to call one, save command, and I'm just going to make this a get, and another one called erase command. And again, it's going to be a get as well. And so what I'm going to do is create them, new them up in my constructor. And so the erase command is a little bit easier, so I'm going to just do erase command equals new command. And into the constructor there, what I'm going to do is just pass an action that I want to have invoked every time the command gets called. So here, all I need to do is say the note, this property that we just created, I'm going to say string.empty. pretty easy. However, for the save command, I'm going to do something a little bit different. First, I'm going to create a collection, and I'm going to call it observable collection of type string. And what this is going to do, it's going to let me create a list, and anytime this changes, it's going to let the list update. So, in my save command, again, it's just going to be a new command here. First thing I'm going to do is take my all notes. I'm going to add to it. And what I'm going to add is the no property, because I know that's changed and has whatever has been entered in that text field. And then I'm going to say the note is equal to string dot empty. It's pretty neat. That's all I need to do here. So my view model is all set up for me. So then in my main page, first thing I'm going to do is actually import the namespace of my view model. So in XAML, the importing a namespace, which is pretty much like a using statement, looks like XMLNS, and then I can look for something like XAML UI, which happens to be my namespace of where it's defined, and then view models. And so the next thing I'm going to do in my XAML is do a content page dot binding context. And so what this is saying that I'm setting up the bindings for everything to be this next class, which is the main page view model. Cool. And now the fun part, setting up the bindings for everything. So for my editor, I'm going to make the text be equal to binding, and you can see what comes up here is in IntelliSense, I can say the note. Neat. My save button, I have a command equals binding. Again, save note command. I better make sure I have that defined as public, which I did not. Make that the save note command. And then for my erase one, and I'll get rid of that white space. So for now, I'm just going to then add in something called a collection view that'll let me display everything. First thing for that is a do an item source, which lets me tell it where I want to get the data from. And so that's going to be a binding, and that's going to be all notes, which is that collection I just created before. And then it's going to be collection view, that item template. And then data template, and this is all just creating things. So this would be the same no matter what all the time. And then finally, within here, I'm going to do a stack layout. And this is what we talked about before when we're creating the view, a frame, and then finally a label. And it also gets a user binding. And the syntax here is just dot because it's a string coming passed in, and there's no property for that string. So let's run this and see what happens. All right, our application is up and running right now. So I'm going to enter a note, and I'm going to say, hello world. Now, as soon as I did that, my note in the view model should be bound. I'm going to hit save. I hit save, and you can see that hello world came in at the top of the screen. Well, that's because I didn't set the grids in my collection view. So using some XAML, I'm going to do grid.row equals to 3, and I'm going to do a grid.columnSpan equals 2. Now I don't necessarily have to do a grid.column equals 0 because it automatically assumes that. I hit save and I'll do hello world yet one more time. Come down, I hit save, and you can see it happened right at the bottom. And maybe I'll just make my text font size a little bit bigger here. We'll make that title. Save it one last time. And you can see it comes in big, says hello world. And what's cool, my delete also works. I just have hello, hit delete, and it disappears. So now we have MBVM working. We have properties bound to the UI. We have commands reacting to the user's actions. And so in the next episode, we are going to show how to add navigation to our app by using the Xamarin Forms built-in navigation framework. So check it out.